आर्टिकल 24 रोड रेल और इनलैंड वाटरवे ट्रांसपोर्ट डॉक्यूमेंट्स। ए रोड रेल और इनलैंड वाटरवे ट्रांसपोर्ट डॉक्यूमेंट हावर नेम्ड मस्ट अपियर टू इंडिकेट द नेम ऑफ द कैरियर एंड बी साइंड बाय द कैरियर और ए नेम्ड एजेंट फॉर और ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द कैरियर। इंडिकेट रिसीप्ट ऑफ द गुड्स बाई सिग्नेचर स्टैम्प और नोटेशन बाई द कैरियर और नेम्ड एजेंट फॉर और ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द कैरियर। एनी सिग्नेचर स्टैम्प और नोटेशन ऑफ रिसीप्ट ऑफ द गुड्स बाई द कैरियर और एजेंट मस्ट बी आइडेंटिफाइड एज दैट ऑफ द कैरियर और एजेंट। एनी सिग्नेचर स्टैम्प और नोटेशन ऑफ रिसीप्ट ऑफ द गुड्स बाई द एजेंट must indicate that the agent has signed or acted for or on behalf of the carrier. If a rail transport document does not identify the carrier, any signature or stamp of the railway company will be accepted as evidence of document being signed by the carrier. 2. Indicate the date of shipment or the date of the goods have been received for shipment, dispatch or carriage at the place stated in the credit. Unless the transport document contains a dated reception stamp, an indication of the date of receipt or date of shipment, the date of issuance of the transport document will be deemed to be the date of shipment. 3. Indicate the place of shipment and the place of destination stated in the credit. B. A road transport document must appear to be the original for consignor or shipper or bear no marking indicating for whom the document has been prepared. A rail transport document marked duplicate will be accepted as an original. A rail or inland waterway transport document will be accepted as an original whether marked as an original or not. In the absence of an indication of the transport document as to the number of originals issued, the number presented will be deemed to constitute a full set. For the purpose of this article, transshipment means unloading from one means of conveyance and reloading to another means of conveyance within the same mode of transport during the carriage from the place of shipment, dispatch or carriage to the place of destination stated in the credit. E1. A road, rail or inland waterway transport document may indicate that the goods will or may be transshipped provided that the entire carriage is covered by one or the same transport document. 2. A road, rail or inland waterway transport document indicating that transshipment will or may take place is acceptable even if the credit prohibits transshipment. Article 25. Courier receipt, post receipt or certificate of posting. A courier receipt, however named evidencing receipt of goods for transport, must appear to indicate the name of the courier service and be stamped or signed by the named courier service at the place from which the credit states the goods are to be shipped and indicate the date of pickup or of receipt or ordering to this effect. This date will be deemed to be the date of shipment. B. A requirement that courier charges are to be paid or prepaid may be satisfied by a transport document issued by a courier service evidencing that courier charges are for the account of the party other than the consignee. A post courier or certificate of posting, however named evidencing receipt of goods for transport, must appear to be stamped or signed and dated at the place from which the credit states the goods are to be shipped This date will be deemed to be the date of shipment. Article 26. On deck, shippers load and count, said by shipper to contain and charges additional to freight. A. The transport document must not indicate that the goods are or will be loaded on deck. A clause on a transport document stating that the goods may be loaded on deck is acceptable. A transport document bearing a clause such as shipper's load and count and said by shipper to contain is acceptable. A transport document may bear a reference by stamp or otherwise to charges additional to the freight. Okay. Article 27. Clean transport document. A bank will accept a clean transport document. A clean transport document is one bearing no clause or notation expressly declaring a defective condition of the goods or their packaging. The word clean need not be appear on a transport document, even if a credit has a requirement for that transport document to be clean on board. Article 28. Insurance document and coverage. A. An insurance document such as an insurance policy, an insurance certificate or a declaration under an open cover must appear to be issued and signed by an insurance company, an underwriter or their agents or their proxies. Any signature by the agent or proxy must indicate whether the agent or proxy has signed for or on behalf of the insurance company or underwriter. B. When the insurance document indicates that it has been issued in more than one original, all originals must be presented. C. Cover notes will not be accepted. D. An insurance policy is acceptable in lieu of an insurance certificate or a declaration under an open cover. E. The date of insurance document must be no later than the date of shipment, unless it appears from the insurance document that the cover is effective from a date not later than the date of shipment. I. The insurance document must indicate the amount of insurance coverage and be the same currency as the credit. A requirement in the credit for insurance coverage to be for a percentage of the value of the goods of the invoice value or similar is deemed to be minimum amount of coverage required. If there is no indication in the credit of the insurance coverage required, the amount of insurance coverage must be at least 110% of the CIF or CIP value of the goods. When the CIF or CIP value cannot be determined from the documents, the amount of insurance coverage must be calculated on the basis of the amount for which honor or negotiation is requested, or the gross value of the goods as shown on the invoice, whichever is greater. The insurance document must indicate that risks are covered at least between the place of taking in charge or shipment and the place of discharge or final destination as stated in the credit. G. A credit should state the type of insurance required and, if any, the additional risks to be covered. An insurance document will be accepted without regard to any risk that are not covered. If the credit uses imprecise terms such as usual risk or customary risk. When a credit requires insurance against all risk and an insurance document is presented containing any all risk notation or clause, whether or not bearing the heading all risk, the insurance document will be accepted without regard to any risk stated to be excluded. An insurance document may contain reference to any exclusion clause. J. An insurance document may indicate that the cover is subject to a franchise or excess deductible. Article 29. Extension of expiry date or last day for presentation. A. If the expiry date of the credit or the last day for presentation falls on a day when the bank to which presentation is to be made is closed for reasons other than those referred to in Article 36, the expiry date or last day for presentation, as the case may be, will be extended to the first following banking day. B. If presentation is made on the first following banking day, a nominated bank must provide the issuing bank or confirming bank with a statement on its covering schedule that the presentation was made within the time limits extended in accordance with sub-article 29A. The latest date for shipment will be extended as a result of sub-article 29A. Article 30. Tolerance in credit amount, quantity, and unit prices. The words about or approximately used in connection with the amount of the credit or quantity or the unit price stated in the credit are to be construed as allowing a tolerance not to exceed 10% or 10% more or 10% less than the amount, the quantity, or the unit price to which they refer. B. A tolerance not to exceed 5% more or 5% less than the quantity of the goods is allowed, provided the credit does not state the quantity in terms of a stipulated number of packaging units or individual items, and the total amount of the drawings does not exceed the amount of the credit. C. Even when partial shipments are not allowed, a tolerance may not exceed 5% less than the amount of the credit is allowed, provided that the quantity of the goods, if stated in the credit, is shipped in full or a unit price. If stated in the credit is not reduced or that sub-article 30B is not applicable, this tolerance does not apply when the credit stipulates a specific tolerance or uses the expressions referred to in sub-article 30A. Article 31. Partial drawings or shipment. Partial drawings or shipment are allowed. A presentation consisting of more than one set of transport document evidencing shipment commencing on the same means of conveyance and for the same journey, provided they indicate the same destination, will be regarded as covering a partial shipment, even if they indicate different dates of the shipment or different ports of loading, places of taking in charge or dispatch. If the presentation consists of more than one set of transport document, the latest date of shipment as evidenced on any of the sets of transport documents will be regarded as the date of shipment. A presentation consisting of one or more set of transport documents evidencing shipment on more than one means of conveyance within the same mode of transport will be regarded as covering a partial shipment, even if the means of conveyance leave on the same day, for the same destination. C. Representation consisting of more than one courier receipt, post receipt of certificate of posting will not be regarded as a partial shipment. If the courier receipt, post receipt or certificate of posting appear to have been stamped or signed by the same courier or postal service at the same place and date and for the same destination. Article 32. Installment drawings or shipments. If a drawing or shipment by installments within given period is stipulated in the credit and any installment is not drawn or shipped within the period allowed for that installment, the credit ceases to be applicable for that and the subsequent installment and any subsequent installment. Article 33. Hours of presentation. A bank has no obligation to accept a presentation outside of its banking hours. Disclaimer on Article 34. Disclaimer on effectiveness or of documents. A bank assumes no liability or responsibility for the form, sufficiency, accuracy, genuineness, falsification, or legal effect of any document, or for the general or particular conditions stipulated in a document or superimposed thereon, nor does it assume any liability or responsibility for the description, quantity, weight, quality, condition, packaging, delivery, value or existence of the goods, services or other performance represented by any document, or for the good faith or acts or omission, solvency, performance or stating or standing of the consignor, the carrier, the forwarder, the consignee or the insurer of the goods or any other person. Yes. Now Article 35. Disclaimer or on transmission and translation. A bank assumes no liability or responsibility for the consequences arising out of delay, loss in transit, mutilation, or other errors arising in the transmission of any message or delivery of letters or documents. Even such message, letter or documents are transmitted and sent according to the requirements stated in the credit, or when the bank may have taken the initiative in the choice of the delivery service in the absence of such instructions in the credit. If a nominated bank determines that a presentation is complying and forwards the document to the issuing bank or confirming bank, whether or not the nominated bank has honored or negotiated, an issuing bank or confirming bank must honor or negotiate or reimburse that nominated bank, even when the documents have been lost in transit between the nominated bank and the issuing bank or confirming bank, or between confirming bank and the issuing bank. The bank assumes no liability or responsibility for errors in translation or interpretation of technical terms and any and may transmit credit terms without translating them. Now Article 36. Force majeure. A bank assumes no liability or responsibility for the consequences arising out of the interruption of its business by acts of God, riots, civil commotions, insurrections, wars, acts of terrorism, or by any strikes or lockouts or any other causes beyond its control. A bank will not, upon resumption of its business, honor or negotiate under a credit that expired during such interruption of its business. Article 36 says, or also Article 37, disclaimer for acts of an instructed party. A bank utilizing the services of another bank for the purpose of giving effect to the instructions of the applicant does so for the account and at the risk of the applicant. An issuing bank or advising bank assumes no liability or responsibility should the instructions it transmits to another bank not be carried out, even if it has taken the initiative in the choice of that another bank. C. A bank instructing another bank to perform services is liable for any commissions, fees, costs, or expense charges incurred by that bank in connection with that instructions. If a credit states that charges are for account of the beneficiary and charges cannot be collected or deducted from proceeds, the issuing bank remains liable for payment of the charges. D. A credit or amendment should not stipulate that the advising to a beneficiary is conditional upon receipt of the advising bank or second advising bank of its charges. The applicant shall be bound by and liable to indemnify a bank against all obligations and responsibilities imposed by foreign laws and uses. Article 38, transferable credits. A bank is under no obligation to transfer a credit except to the extent and in the manner expressly consented to by that bank. B. For the purpose of this article, transferable credit means a credit that specifically states it is transferable. A transferable credit may be made available in whole or in part of another beneficiary, bracket second beneficiary, at the request of the beneficiary, first beneficiary. Transferring bank means a nominated bank that transfers the credit or in a credit available with any bank. A bank that is specifically authorized by the issuing bank to transfer and that transfers the credit an issuing bank may be a transferring bank. Transferred credit means a credit that has been made available by the transferring bank to a second beneficiary. C. Unless otherwise agreed at the time of transfer, all charges, such as commissions, fees, costs, or expense incurred in respect of a transfer must be paid by the first beneficiary. D. A credit may be transferred in part to more than one second beneficiary, provided partial drawings or shipments are allowed. A transferred credit cannot be transferred at the request of a second beneficiary to any subsequent beneficiary. The first beneficiary is not considered to be a subsequent beneficiary. Any request for transfer must indicate if and under what conditions amendments may be advised to the second beneficiary. The transferred credit must clearly indicate those conditions. If a credit is transferred to more than one second beneficiary, rejection of an amendment by one or more second beneficiary does not invalidate the acceptance by any other second beneficiary with respect to which the transferred credit will be amended accordingly. For any second beneficiary that rejected the amendment, the transferee credit will remain unassessed, unamended. Z. The transferred credit must accurately reflect the terms and conditions of the credit, including the confirmation, if any, with the exception of the amount of the credit, any unit price stated therein, the expiry date, the period for presentation, or the latest date, the latest shipment date, or given period for shipment, any or all of which may be reduced or curtailed. The percentage for which insurance cover must be effected may be increased to provide the amount of cover stipulated in the credit or these articles. The name of the first beneficiary may be substituted for that of the applicant in the credit. If the name of the applicant is specifically required by the credit to appear in any document other than the invoice, such requirement must be reflected in the transferred credit. The first beneficiary has the right to substitute its own invoice and draft, if any, for those of a second beneficiary for an amount not to excess of that stipulated in the credit. And upon such substitution, the first beneficiary can draw under the credit for the differences, if any, between its invoice and the invoice of the second beneficiary. If the first beneficiary is to present its own invoice and draft, if any, but fails to do so on first demand, or if the invoices presented by the first beneficiary create discrepancies that did not exist in the presentation made by the second beneficiary, and the first beneficiary fails to correct them on first demand, and the transferring bank has the right to present the documents as received from the second beneficiary to the issuing bank without further responsibility to the first beneficiary. J. The first beneficiary may, in its request for transfer, indicate that honor or negotiation is to be effected to a second beneficiary at a place to which the credit has been transferred, up to and including the expiry date of the credit. This is without prejudice to the right of the first beneficiary in accordance with Article 38A. K. Presentation of documents by or on behalf of a second beneficiary must be made to the transferring bank. 38 Article 39. Assignment of proceeds. The fact that the credit is not stated to be transferable shall not affect the right of the beneficiary to assign any proceeds to which it may be or may become entitled under the credit, in accordance with the provisions of applicable law. This article relates only to the assignment of proceeds and not to the assignments of the right to perform under the credit. Yes.